It's your boy Dinpur Randhawa back with another Arsenal News episode. Well, ladies and gentlemen, trust me, for the first time in 3 days, I am actually going to have more Arsenal news than the Super League news, because the reality of the Super League, of course, we're going to talk about why exactly it had to end, the real reason why the Super League has to end, because Andrea Agnelli has opened up about it. And it makes a lot of sense. It really makes a lot of sense. And all of you guys, I think I thought Boris Johnson is just a... I don't know what is he doing. Like, is he even powerful enough? Trust me, he is. He has done wonders, and there's a big reason why Boris Johnson was the main catalyst for the ESL to actually disband. So let's just talk about Florentino Perez. Now, his relationship is totally broken with a lot of presidents of different clubs. This will be difficult for us to negotiate for Martin Odegaard in the future, and I think no Martin Odegaard for Arsenal anymore. We just have to live with that. So here's the latest update about the injury news that we have here from Arsenal. So we're going to talk about it. As said, Alex Lacazette, left hamstring. Alex has sustained a strain to his left hamstring and will be unavailable for the Friday's game, as will be assessed. And Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang, Oba continues to recover after contracting malaria on international duty. He will be unavailable for the game against Everton, but is hoping to resume light training by the end of this week. So sad news, no Aubameyang, but good news, Lacazette has only suffered a strain. It's just a grade 1 strain, so he would be available, I think, for the Villarreal game. It's just a strain. He needs to relax, get into some relaxed mode till Saturday, and then some training from Sunday. So that could be fine, I guess. So David Luiz says, right knee, David is making very good progress and is hoping to integrate back into light training with the squad next week. That implies that we could definitely have him very soon. Martin Odegaard, right ankle. Martin is now back in light training and will be assessed ahead of Everton's match regarding his availability, which tells me that he might be back. And also, Kieran Tierney, left knee. Kieran sustained ligament damage to his left knee. There was no further health or injury issues. All other players in the men's first team are currently available for selection. Kieran continues to make positive progress and is hoping to be back in training within 2 or 3 weeks. So, strong possibilities if Arsenal make the finals. Kieran Tierney will be available very, very soon. So, moving on. So, winner Venkatesham has offered to speak to any player on a 1v1 basis, and the players have been urged to focus on the run-in with the club still in the Europa League semi-finals with Villarreal next week. Venkatesham has also communicated with other staff at the club to reiterate the apology and explain their position. Now, Vinay Venkatesham has addressed Arsenal players and manager Mikel Arteta at a meeting at London Colney on Wednesday morning. He has apologized to the whole first team squad over the European Super League fiasco. It is understood Venkatesham spoke to the whole group, explained the reasoning behind it, but apologized fully for putting them through the mess for the last 48 goddamn hours. So here's the reality. Forward Balogun has officially signed his contract extension with Arsenal. He has signed a 4-year deal. Official confirmation from Arsenal very much imminent. So that is the reality, ladies and gentlemen. And that is the truth. So moving on. So Sky News claim executives from clubs which sparked a civil war in English football by joining the now abandoned European Super League have been handed an ultimatum to step down from key Premier League subcommittees. Now, Sky News has learned that Richard Masters, the Premier League chief executive, contacted executives on Wednesday, including Bruce Buck, the Chelsea chairman, and Vinay Venkatesham, the chief executive of Arsenal, to request that they relinquish their roles on the working groups. Sad but true. So, Willian, on his future with Arsenal, in an interview says, "My plan is to stay at Arsenal, have a contract here, and to win trophies. I have 2 more years here and my plan is to stay and be successful, to play and win something with the club. I still want to achieve a lot of things. I want to win more trophies and I want to be at the World Cup. I will do my best to be there, but yeah, I want to lift trophies for Arsenal. I have a lot of things in my mind that I want to achieve. I want to win as much as I can with the team." Now, back to the bloody Super League. Ramon Calderon, ex-Real Madrid president, has spoken about Florentino Perez. He says, "I think it has been hugely embarrassing. Besides, I believe he has led in a grotesque way. If we can say it, attending late night TV shows and claiming he was coming to save football." Super savage from Ramon Calderon. Also, the Times have reported that UEFA is set to be hit with a concerted campaign to drop its plan for 2 Champions League places awarded on the basis of historical performances in Europe. Ladies and gentlemen, Kanu has opened up about Alex Iwobi. He says, I was surprised Arsenal let Alex Iwobi go when they did. He was supposed to be a part of this team, and I think they would be a better team with him in it. He's Arsenal blood, and he's always given his all for the team. Very well. So officially, Juventus and AC Milan have come up with their comunicado official, which mentions that they have left the Super League, and they apologize. I don't even know if there's an official apology, but yes. Also, Arsenal are bracing for a fan protest ahead of their game against Everton on Friday, with supporters angry at owner Stan Kroenke's involvement in the failed launch of the Super League. And now, Andrea Agnelli says, I'm not going to say how many clubs contacted me in just 24 hours, asking if they could join. Maybe they lied, but I was contacted by a number of teams asking what they could do to join. This could be false as well. Could be false. Anyways. We could be seeing more than we should, but yeah, that's that. So moving on, so talking about other different stuff that we got for you guys over here is that Kaveh Solikol says on Sky, says about the Super League, I know of one executive, a senior executive, who basically runs one of these clubs on a day-to-day basis, who knew absolutely nothing about this until he was told that it had happened, and his club has signed up to it. I think that was Paolo Maldini, the AC Milan. Yes, the AC Milan guy. That's the guy. Okay. So it has been reported that former Arsenal midfielder Jack Wilshere, currently at Bournemouth, is rumored to be joining protests against Stan Kroenke outside the Emirates Stadium on Friday evening. Just a rumor, guys. Don't get ahead of yourselves, but you know what? Jack really is back. What a turnaround. Lovely. Great to see that from Jack. But moving on, so we further go on with Andrea Agnelli, the Juventus chairman, says, I have had speculation that to that end, that if six teams would have broken away and would have threatened the EPL, politics would have seen that as an attack to Brexit and their political scheme. And he has claimed that Boris Johnson forced the collapse of the Super League as he feared it would undermine Brexit. That is the reality, ladies and gentlemen, which Andrea Agnelli has come up with. So, it's not a small thing that has happened. It's a very big thing, and it's shameful. And yes, Arsenal made a boo-boo. The big question is, how are they going to come clean from this? I have seriously no idea, but let's see what happens. So, well, Arsenal players actually listened intently to Vinay Venkatesham's apology and did have questions, especially around why there has been not been any consolation, but all of the clubs were bound by confidentially because of the legal complexities of the breakaway group. And there was lots of issues with that. I'll tell you. It's reality. It is reality. So here's official news from Voidball Ultras. Schalke's players, including Sead Kolasinac and Shkodran Mustafi, had to flee from an angry mob of fans last night after their 1-0 loss away to Arminia Bielefeld confirmed their relegation to Bundesliga. So they've been relegated, ladies and gentlemen, Schalke, and they chased down those players. Chased down, man. That itself is so bad. So pretty darn bad. Wow. It's not a very good behavior. Now, no matter whatever they did at Arsenal, no matter that I know what kind of footballers they are, I'll be true with you. I think this is not the way to actually, you may hate someone, but chasing someone down, wow. That's the lowest. That's the lowest, man. These ultras are really, really not. I don't get it. I don't get this kind of a reaction, but okay. Oh. According to Sport Witness, Arsenal are considering a move for Julian Draxler this summer. With his Paris Saint-Germain contract coming to an end, Draxler's future at Paris Saint-Germain is still uncertain, and he's on a very broad list of possible signings at Arsenal this summer. Now, see, still a big choice for Arsenal to go through, but let's see. The Big Six rebels have lost tens of millions between them in their disastrous attempts to set up the European Super League, which ended in humiliating defeat. It looks like they have purchased equity stakes of around £8 million each in the Super League. That could definitely be haunting and daunting at the moment. So let's see how Arsenal will deal with this in the coming future. Well, right now they have to deal with an angry mob, or rather an angry bunch of players waiting for their players and every single one of them outside the stadium for the Everton game. What will happen? I'll let you know if something special happens. So with this, we end this episode. I will see you in the next one. Until then, cheers. And don't forget to subscribe, of course. Cheers.